Many friends and family here with us tonight.
Yay!
Thank you! And it's been quite a while since we've put on a concert. And so with me ringing tonight, if you just ring one of your exciting, most heaviest bells. Exciting, most heaviest.
Oh, that's so, a problem.
starting on this side, this is Charity. This is Karen. This is Pat. This is Mary. Over here, I've got Pam, Jean, Susie, Cheryl, and our most newest member, Bobby.
Wow.
And I'm just thrilled to pieces. So most of us have been ringing together since August of 2002. Last year, Jean joined us almost a year to the day. And then our most recent is Bobby. And so she's only been a month and a half.
At the most,
not very long.
This is her first day. I mean, well, concert.
And I'm very famous for jumping people in both feet. So she's going to be playing three songs with us. And so we'll let you know when. We are going to play two songs where we sing. When we did that, it was 8 years before we could ring and sing.
Oh, wow.
Bobby's done this in less than a month. She can ring and sing. So she is miles ahead of us.
Wow. I can sing, it would help.
So we're going to open the concert with Star Spangled Banner. It is not required to stand up on this, but if you want to sing, you can. And here we go. Do full measures plus pickup. If you're left-handed, you'd understand what I'm talking about. The next piece we're going to play is called It's a Three-Ring Circus. And we have a xylophone over here that is going to help us out with this piece. Many of you might remember the Barnum Bailey Circus Troupe that would come to town in the dead of the night. They'd set up their tents, and then the excitement would start to build. The trapeze artists, the elephants, and so many clowns stuffed into that little Volkswagen Bug. Well, the music would be so familiar and energetic, the anticipation and thrill of the lion act. Well, with luck, our rendition will help stir up and inspire some of those very fond memories that you had. This piece was written for handbells by Daryl Day. Let's see how we go.
Thank you.
Of Maine. He first joined the Shakers in Maine when his father's farm helped to form the nucleus of the new Shaker settlement. Another name for this song is Lord of the Dance. The lyrics were by Alfred Hart Miles. It was written by Charles Zimmerman. At the time, Zimmerman was a lieutenant, and he had been a bandmaster of the United States Naval Academy Band. Miles was a midshipman, first class at the Academy in the class of 1907. He assisted in composing the song for that class to be used as a football march. Anyways, he later wrote and adapted the song, and it now has a third verse. But this is our rendition of Anchors Away.
Two measures to start. One, two, three, four.
I-N-G. Marching Home. It was written by an Irish-American band leader, Patrick Gilmore, during the American Civil War. It was immensely popular, and it was sung by both sides of the American Civil War, and it also became a hit in England. All right, when Johnny Comes Marching Home. Did I talk long enough?
Slower.
Oh yeah, come in on four. Second time. Second time coming on four. Thank you. Yes. Oh, I love it when I have help. I am going to count to six, and then I'll count to four in a second. One, two, three, four.
Thank you.
actually written for handbells, but I found it on the internet, you know, when you do those Google searches, and I really liked it. It's written by Johann Sebastian Bach and from Jethro Tull. Well, come to find out, the Jethro fellow was quite a famous flutist. And the song is called Bourée. It's a dance of French origin, along with the words and music that accompany it. And I can't even pronounce the French word, so you can make up whatever you want, and I'll believe you if you talk French. But anyways, many renditions of this piece can be heard as the background mood music in movies, so you might recognize it. It also was used when they were teaching people how to do ballet. They used it for doing, what do they call it, pirouettes? Is that? That fancy ballet stuff. Anyways, this is Bourée. Deep breath, go slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3.
Fentanyl, someone has stolen my F. This will be better. Maybe.
Is everybody else ready? We obviously can pronounce the song right, though. Okay, so this is Bourée, not bored.
Okay.
One more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. Gifted and talented, he just scribbled it out on a piece of scratch paper when he was traveling on the train. It was a ride from Manhattan, New York. Northwark then provided those paper scraps to Albert von Tilsler, who composed the music, which in turn was published and before the year was over and became a hit song. Well, Jack Northwark was a vaudeville actor and entertainer. And so it was nothing for him to come up with things in 15 minutes or less. And but anyways, there was a pitcher, Larry Anderson. Maybe some of you might have recognized the name. But he's like, why would you sing a song at the seventh inning stretch that says, take me out to the ball game, if you're already there. He says, that's the most silliest thing, and only a moron would do that. However, I guess we all fall into that category because we still do it. But with the help of Cheryl, she's going to get us kind of started on this. There will be parts where we'll sing, and Bobby will clue you in when you can sing along with us.
And I think the most interesting thing is neither one of these fellows that wrote this song had ever been to a baseball game.
Serious?
One measure was two.
Welcome to beautiful Lake Cole Field here at the corner of Edgar Martinez Way and Daisy House Drive, the best address in America, home of your Seattle Mariners, fighting for their playoff lives in the year 2017. Here is the little known first verse of Take Me Out to the Ball Game. Katie Casey was baseball mad, had the fever and had it bad, just to root for the hometown crew. Every Sue, that's money, Katie Blue. On a Saturday, her young beau boyfriend called to see if she'd like to go to see a show, but Miss Kate said no. I'll tell you what you can do. You can come to beautiful Safeco Field, home of your Seattle Mariners, and at the seventh inning stretch, you'll sing the chorus of this beautiful song as soon as we get there.
Because I've always lost during this song because I haven't got a clue.
Are we close?
Close.
We're not close. Okay, I should talk some more. We're starting the series with whatever the name of that team is.
For the
with us is called I'll Fly Away. It was written by Albert E. Brumley, and it was described as a preeminent gospel songwriter of the 20th century, and he published over 600 songs. I'll Fly Away is a hymn written in 1929, published in 1932, and titled The Wonderful Message, I'll Fly Away. It's been called the most recorded gospel song. It appears in many hymnals, where it's listed under the topics of eternal life, heaven and acceptance. That's hard to say, sorry, but we've all been accepted, right? And it's a standard song at bluegrass jam sessions and is often performed at funerals. Today is not a funeral, but we're going to play it anyways. All right. Two measures to start.
Thank you.
concert come to an end, because we do have a lot of fun when we play for you. But this last piece is The Wizard of Oz.
Yay.
And it has several different medleys from the movie in there. It was arranged by Douglas Wagner, who is a handbell enthusiast. So he's got in there different techniques that we can use. It includes Ding Dong, The Witch is Dead, We're Off to See the Wizard, The Merry Old Land of Oz, and Over the Rainbow. The lyrics for the movie was written by E.Y. Yip Harburg, and he referred to these as lemon drop songs. And I'm not quite sure what that meant, but maybe you do. We really enjoyed sharing the evening with you, and hopefully you'll enjoy this last piece, The Wizard of Oz.
I have too many bells. Anybody want to come play?
you're like kidding, right?
Too late.
Too late, yeah.
Just suck it up.